Hi there, this is Mary Poplin with Boris FX, and this is another Mocha Pro quick tip. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about what happens when your clip is actually longer than your comp and how that affects your tracking data and how to fix it. Let me show you what that looks like. If I drag and drop Mocha Pro onto my clip and then launch Mocha Pro, inside of Mocha Pro, I can draw a nice shape around this hat. And let's just track translation only and track forwards. Notice that my entire timeline got loaded into Mocha Pro and not just the clip that was visible inside of my comp. Why does that matter? Well, it actually affects the way that the data will be pasted back into After Effects. Since Mocha's reading from the timeline, when I paste the data back into After Effects, Mocha will assume that the timeline is actually 572 frames long, and it's not. So let's show you what that means. And to illustrate the problem more effectively, I'm going to show you the old school way of applying tracking data. Let's stop tracking. Let's export our track data. I'm going to select After Effects transform data and copy that to the clipboard. Save and close. Let's make a new null object. Notice that my null starts at frame 200. If I select my null and go to Edit, Paste, notice how my null does not move at all. But if you scroll through the timeline, you can see that the tracking data does not actually change until we get towards the end of the shot. Now, why is that? That's because we have a 200 frame buffer at the beginning of the shot. So how do we get around this? One of the ways around this is to use a newer version of Mocha Pro or Mocha AE. What that will do is allow you to create your tracking data, select what kind of tracking data you'd like to apply, select the layer you'd like to apply it to, and hit Apply Export. Now your tracking data will move correctly in most cases. Another way around this is to simply precomp your layer. So back in our original comp, you can see that the header of the footage shoots off the timeline to the left. And you can also see a tail at this end of the timeline. If we select Layer and precompose and move all the attributes into the new composition and hit OK. Now look, my footage is neatly enveloped. If I drag Mocha back onto this precomp, we're still reading from the timeline. When I launch Mocha, you can see that now my timeline looks correct. Let's draw a new shape around our hat, track translation only, and turn the surface tool on. Let's hit track forwards. Once my track is complete, we can check and make sure that it's following along with the hat. And it is. Let's export our tracking data. Let's do After Effects transform data and copy to clipboard. Save and close. Let's add a new null object by selecting Layer, New, Null Object, Edit, Paste. And now you can see that my track moves correctly. This technique works whether or not you are copying and pasting from After Effects, whether or not you are using Create Track Data and applying transform data or a corner pin. And especially, this is a good technique to use if you are using a round trip comp from Premiere. In fact, anytime I have a dynamically linked comp, I always precompose it and move all the attributes into the new composition. Notice too how this composition is only one clip. You don't want to apply Mocha to one of many clips in a comp. You want to isolate each shot into its own comp. If you follow this simple rule, usually your exported data will line up when you export it. If you're using a new version of Mocha Pro or Mocha AE, pre-comping is not always necessary. So I want to reiterate the importance of using the plugin interface. Select what kind of tracking data you'd like to apply. Select the layer you'd like to apply it to, and hit Apply Export. Now your tracking data will move correctly in most cases. However, just like using the plugin interface is best practices for applying tracking data, using precomps to set up your shot is also best practices so that you don't run into any problems. Learning more about Mocha has never been easier. You can stream our Mocha Essentials series for free at borisfx.com. And there you will also find free training, forums, support, and so much more.